أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وبه نستعين إنه خير ناصر ومعين الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين شفيع المذنبين رحمة للعالمين سيدنا ونبينا وشفي ذنوبنا وحبيب قلوبنا وطبيب نفوسنا الذي سمي في السماء بأحمد وفي الأرضين بأبي القاسم المصطفى محمد وبآله الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين صلوات الله عليهم أجمعين ولعنة الله على أعدائهم ومنكر فضائلهم وغاصب حقوقهم من الأولين والآخرين من الآن إلى قيام يوم الدين أما بعد فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في كتابه المجيد وكلامه الكريم وقوله الحق بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لو كنا نسمع أو نعقل ما كنا في أصحاب السعير آمنا بالله وصدق الله العلي العظيم صلوا على محمد وآل محمد In such tragic events, when we lose our brother, our close brother, a believer who's very close to the masjid. He's got a special relation with the masjid. Your presence, such a good attendance in a short notice on a weekday, proves the nobility of Marhum. It proves how he had relation with the people of this community. Not only that, as I entered the mosque today to lead salah, those musallin who are very regular, who have been very regular, they were praising him. And they were saying that it was only last night he was with us, just praying besides us. Not only that, but he proclaimed adhan. He led salah, he prayed salah with us. He was in akhirah seminar. In other words, he came out from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he went to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It was the darbar of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It was masjid, the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with that sanctity, that holy sanctuary. He left the holy sanctuary and he went back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abbas bhai is very well known to us. We all know him. His relation with people, he was very warm-hearted. He had good relations with each and every person in the community. Not only with elderly people, people of his age, but even with children. And that was witnessed. We could see him speaking to children. How he would speak to the children. How he would treat the children. This is exactly the hadith of Amir al-Mu'minin Ali ibn Abi Talib, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi. It matches with the hadith of Ali alayhi salam when he says in Nahj al-Balagha that live amongst people in such a way that when you are not there, they yearn for you. They yearn for you. They want to meet you. They miss you. The presence of all of you tonight coming here at this masjid, at Imam Bargah, to mourn, to remember this mu'min, it is a good sign for a mu'min. Indeed. Allahumma la na'al mu'min illa khaira. We don't know anything from him. Minhu illa khaira. What we know is only good. We have just witnessed good from him. Imagine sudden death is, according to our sixth holy imam. Sixth imam says that a believer is lucky if he's attacked by a sudden death. He's lucky. Because he has escaped all those calamities. And we were just discussing with other Mu'minin that he didn't become muhtaj of anything. He didn't become muhtaj. He was not helpless. He didn't need anybody. It was so sudden that some Mu'minin were not aware when we came for Salah, and they were not aware. He passed away. We said, yes. He said he was with us last night and he passed away. It was so sudden, so quick. However, there's another hadith of Imam Sadiq also, which says that a believer, again, he is lucky. If he spends his time in illness, then his sins are wiped off. So in any case, a believer is lucky. Whether he is in illness, his sins are wiped off. And if he passes away suddenly, he's still lucky, Imam Sadiq says. Why? Because he has escaped all those problems and calamities. And Allah took him to his darbar. In such events, we need to take some lessons. We need to take some ibrat. The way Amirul Mumineen Ali ibn Abi Talib salawatullahi wa salam alayhi says. He says, take lesson, take ibrat. Then he continues. He says in Hajj al-Balagha, he says that the ibrat are so many. The lessons are so many. But to gain lessons are very few. It's very true. So many deaths and demise we witness. Every kind of death. Cardiac arrest, which is so sudden. We have just witnessed. And we hear different kinds of age of people pass away. We hear, don't we? But then it affects us just for a while. Then again we forget. Again we sin. Again we are in heedlessness. Again we are in ghafla. Ghafla is heedlessness. Again we are heedless of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is why we are told that keep ready your kafan. So that you do not be remorseful. So that you do not repent. So that you do not regret on the day of Yawmul Hasra. From the names of Qiyamah, one name is Yawmul Hasra. Hasra is to regret, to repent. On the day of judgment, many people will repent. Many people will regret that we had time, but we did not use wisely. That we had the time, but we did not value the time which we had. So that we should not regret on the day of judgment, on Yawmul Hasra. When we take Ibrah, there are many ahadith, we could say. But then I chose a verse of Quran, which you heard right now from Surah Mulk, verse number 10. لَوْ كُنَّا نَسْمَوْ أَوْ نَعْكِلُ مَا كُنَّا فِي أَصْحَابِ السَّعِيرِ, which means that on the day of judgment, in the fire of hell, the people of hell will be saying, if we would have listened, لَوْ كُنَّا نَسْمَوْ أَوْ نَعْكِلُ, or if we would have used our common sense, ما كنا في أصحاب السعير, we would have not been from the people of the fire of hell. But because we did not use our aql. In another hadith, the sixth holy imam says that if you want to go to paradise, use your aql. Why? Because through this aql, Allah is worshipped. ما عبد به الرحمن واكتسب به الجنان. And the paradises are attained through this aql. And even the people of hell will say that if you would have used our aql, we would have not reached here. But because we didn't use aql, that is why we are here. Imam Sadiq says that Allah has blessed a believer with four pearls. With four pearls. And besides that four pearls, Allah has kept other things which pollute these four pearls. Now, what are those four pearls? And what are those things which pollute these four pearls? It will be interesting for us to know that what are those four pearls? The first pearl is aql. Aql. It's a pearl for us. It's very valuable. Just now, if you have a pearl, then you will protect it. You won't throw it. Why? Because it's very valuable. Bo kimti che. Etle mate to apre. Find it a sanjsu, a protect kursu. So, akl is a pearl for us. the thing which pollutes aql is anger, Imam Sadiq says. And that is why Imam Ali alayhi salam says that when a person becomes angry, he becomes a toy in the hands of shaitan. And then shaitan throws him wherever he wants. Or interestingly, Imam Ali alayhi salam says in Najm al-Balagha that anger starts with madness and it ends with regretness. So, the first pearl is aql. And the thing which pollutes aql is anger. The second pearl is religion. We are blessed with this religion. There are so many religions in the world. If you work in RE, in religious studies, or RS, whatever you call it, or religious education, you'll see that there are many religions. There are people without religions. But then think about them. Kullu nafsin dhaikatul maut. Every soul has to test death. We have got such a beautiful religion which explains us about hereafter, which gives us peace and tranquility and comfort if we lose our father or if we lose a person who is very close to us, a very beloved to us. Religion will give us tranquility. Karbala will give us peace and comfort. If we remember the masaib of Husayn ibn Ali alayhi salam, we will get peace and tranquility. Think about those people who don't have religion. Atheists. What would they do? Because they don't have religion. So religion is a pearl for us. Indeed. It is a pearl. Because of that religion we have reached here. We all have gathered. Islam has united us. Because of that religion. It's a pearl. But then what pollutes religion? This is also important for us to know. What pollutes religion? Hasad. Jealousy. Al-hasadu ya'akulul hasanat kama nar ya'akulul hatab. The way fire eats up wood and it turns into ashes, same applies to our good deeds. Our good deeds are being polluted with hasad. And that is why today, if you open Quran speaks about the enemies of Ahlul Bayt. Am yahsuduna an-nas in Surah Nisa. That these people envy Ahlul Bayt, the genealogy and the descendants of Ibrahim, because we gave the descendants of Ibrahim hikmat, kitab, and mulkan azim, that is imama. So all those who are the enemies of Ahlul Bayt, they stood against our imams, they stood against Ahlul Bayt. Why? Because of hasad. Or the brothers of Yusuf, they will be cursed till the day of judgment. Why? Because of that jealousy and envy they had against Yusuf alayhi salam. So the thing which pollutes religion is hasad. The third pearl which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us is haya. Shamefulness, bashfulness, haya, chastity, modesty. Haya is extremely important for us. We all need to have modesty, chastity. But then what pollutes modesty and chastity? Imam Sadiq says that greed pollutes chastity. Greed pollutes modesty. Azra bi nafsihi man istash'ara at-tama. Imam Ali alayhi salam says in Najm al-Balagha that person has degraded himself if he has shown his tama, his greed. Azra bi nafsihi man istash'ara at-tama. The fourth thing and the last thing, the fourth pearl that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us is amalus salih. What is amalus salih? Good deeds. Good deeds is a pearl for us. Protect it. Protect it. Last day before yesterday, in the shahadat of Imam Hasan al-Askari, salatu alayhi wa salamu alayhi. We mentioned hadith of the Holy Prophet of Islam, which says that tasfiyatu amal ashaddu min al-amal, which means that to protect amal is to maintain a good deed is harder than performing a good deed. Tasfiyatu amal ashaddu min al-amal. So amalus salih, which means good deeds, you need to protect it. The thing which pollutes good deeds is ghibah. And what is ghibah? Backbiting. Some people were saying in Iran when we were studying very long ago that if Allah would have accepted and if Allah would have asked us and if He would have told us that which one vice you want me to make lawful for you, then perhaps we could have said ghibah. Do lawful for us. Why? Because we don't have anything to talk. When we go to a gathering, we want something to talk. Yeah? Listen, ghibah, even to listen ghibah is haram. Not a person who initiates is haram, does haram. Even to listen to ghibah is haram. And then what does it do? It pollutes your good deeds, your amul salih. Imam Sadiq says that on the day of judgment, a person will come and will say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, Ya Allah, when he will be given his results slip, he'll be given his report. He'll say, Ya Allah, I have performed Umrah. I have gone to Ziyarah. Every Arbaeen, I've walked from Najaf to Karbala. I've gone to Hajj. I have given charity. I've given everything. I've fasted Sunnat fast in Rajab and Shaaban. Where is it? Where has this gone? There's nothing in my result slip. He'll be told that it is transferred in that mu'min's account whom you have done his ghibah. You have backbitten him. Now your good deeds have gone to his account. So if you are being talked of, somebody talks ill of you behind your back, do not worry. Your sins are being wiped off. Your sins are being wiped off. These are four pearls given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to protect them. Muhtaram Sameen, bahut jaldi main aapki zehmat ko tamam karna chahta hoon. Aqibat bakhair bahut zaruri hai. Hamari dua bhi yahi honi chahiye. Agar aapko yaad ho to humne aapki azhan hai, agar aapki azhan mein ye mehfooz ho ki humne arz ki thi aapki khidmat mein ke Masoom-e-Kum alaihi salam ki shahadat ki shab thi ke Masoom-e-Kum ki ziyarat mein wo ziyarat jo Imam Riza ne document kiya tha usme likha hua hai. Imam Riza ne farmaya کہ آپ اگر دعا کرنا چاہتے ہیں تو آپ اس طریقے سے دعا کریں معصومے کی حرم میں. اللہم انی اسألوکا ان تختم لی بالسعادہ. یاد ہے؟ یعنی او لارڈ make our destiny good. اللہم انی اسألوکا ان تختم لی بالسعادہ. یعنی سعادت کے ساتھ ہماری خاتمہ ہو. یعنی our destiny should be good. یہ بہت ضروری ہے. اور آج بھی یہ مرحوم جو ہمارے درمیان سے چل بسے در حقیقت خدا بہتر جانتا ہے لیکن اس بات کی دلیل ہے کہ آج ہم یہاں پہ سب اکٹھے ہوئے ہیں. ہم نے انگریزی زبان میں بھی عرض کیا تھا آپ کی خدمت میں کہ آج تو ویک ڈے ہے پھر بھی سب لوگ یہاں پہ اتنا سارا مجمع یہاں پہ حاضر ہے. کیوں؟ فقط ابھی تو تشیع جنازہ بھی نہیں ہے لیکن چھٹے امام کی حدیث ہے اگر 40 لوگ فقط کہے کہ یہ اچھا آدمی تھا تو خدا ان کو بخشتا ہے. تو وہ مومن باسعادت ہے, ان کی ڈیسٹینی اچھی ہوتی ہے. خدا ہم سب کی ڈیسٹینی اچھا کرے. ہم سب کو ہماری ہم سب کو اس دنیا سے جب چلے جائے تو باسعادت کے ساتھ چلے جائے, اچھی سعادت ملے ہمیں. یہ بہت ضروری ہے, یہ دعا کرنی چاہیے کہ آخرت بخیر ہو, عاقبت بخیر ہو. ہارون رشید کا ایک لڑکا تھا, ان کا ایک بیٹا تھا جس کا نام تھا قاسم. ہارون رشید ملعون تھا خود. انہوں نے امام موسیٰ کاظم کو زہر دیا, قتل کیا, لیکن ان کا فرزند نیک تھا. ان کی سعادت, ان کی عاقبت اچھی تھی. ان کو موت ملی باسعادت. تعجب کی بات ہے نا, ہارون رشید اور ان کا فرزند. کہتے ہیں کہ وہ رات کے اندھیرے میں جب ان کو پتا چلا کہ اس کے والد ان کو حکومت دینا چاہتا ہے تو رات و رات نکل گیا بغداد سے اور بصرہ کی طرف چلا گیا اور کہنے لگا کہ میں یہاں پہ نہیں رہوں گا. کیوں؟ کیونکہ مجھے حکومت نہیں چاہیے. یہ حکومت ہماری نہیں ہے, حکومت موسیٰ کاظم کی ہے. لہٰذا رات و رات نکل گیا, چلا گیا اور انڈیپینڈنٹ بنا, خود بخود کام کرنے لگا, مزدوری کرنے لگا. عبداللہ بصری کہتے ہیں کہ میں جب بصرے کے بازار میں گیا, میں نے ان کو دیکھا تو مجھے پتا نہیں تھا کہ یہ ہارون کا فرزند ہے, خلیفہ وقت کا فرزند ہے, بادشاہ کا فرزند ہے. مجھے کام پڑا, میرے گھر پہ دیوار گر گئی. میں چاہتا تھا کہ وہ میری دیوار کو بنائے, تو میں نے ان کو التماس کی اور انہوں نے کہا میں مزدوری کروں گا. وہ آیا میرے گھر پہ, اس نے کام کیا, کام کرنے لگا, پھر چلا گیا और मैंने देखा जब नमाज का वक्त होता था तो वो नमाज पढ़ने गया, जोहरेन का वक्त जब होता था नमाज पढ़ने गया। मुझे बहुत ताज्जुब हुआ, वुजू बावजू जल्दी नमाज पढ़ के दोबारा काम को इदामा देता था। थोड़ी देर के बाद, कुछ दिनों के बाद मुझे पता चला कि कासिम वो लड़का जो मजदूरी करता था तुम्हारे यहां, वो तो बिस्तर मौत पे है, अस्पताल में है। तो मैंने लोगों से कहा कि आप मुझे ले चले ताकि मैं उनकी आयादत करूं। मैं गया आयादत के लिए तो मैंने कहा क्या हाल है, तो उसने कहा कि मैं बिस्तर मौत पे हूं, ये मेरा आखिरी लम्हा है। आया कुछ वसीयत है? कहा हाँ, मेरी तीन वसीयत है। पहली वसीयत ये है कि हर सोम, आज भी सोम का दिन है, हर सोम मेरे वालिद जो है खलीफा वक्त है, अब्दुल्ला बसरी कहता है कि मैं लड़स गया जब मुझे पता चला कि ये खलीफा वक्त का फर्जंद है, मैं लड़सने लगा। कहा हर सोम मेरे वालिद जो है ओपन फोरम रखता है, लोग आते हैं उनको मिलने मुलाकात के लिए, मेरे वालिद को सलाम कहना और उनको अंगूठी देना, ये उनकी अंगूठी है, उनसे कहना कि मेरी मौत हो गई और मैं मुलाकात न कर पाया, मेरा फकत सलाम भेजना। दूसरी वसीयत ये है कि मेरे पास मेरा कुरान है और मेरे इक्विपमेंट्स है मजदूरी के, ये हर किसी को देना जो इसको इस्तेमाल करेगा, कुरान उसको देना जो इस्तेमाल करेगा, जो पढ़ेगा, जो तिलावत करेगा, मेरे इक्विपमेंट्स भी उसको देना जो इस्तेमाल करेगा। और आखिरी ज़हमत ये है कि आओ मेरे शाने को हिलाओ। कहा क्यों? कहा मैं देखता हूं कि अमीरुल मोमिनीन आते हैं, अली अलैहि सलाम आते हैं, ताकि मैं उनकी ताजीम के लिए उठूं, मेरे शाने को हिलाओ। अब्दुल्ला बसरी कहते कि मैंने उनके शाने को हिलाया, उन्होंने बाकायदा देखा कि अमीरुल मोमिनीन आते हैं और उसी वक्त उसने दम तोड़ दिया। इसको कहते हैं आकिबत बखैर, आकिबत बखैर, पता चल जाता है कौन मोमिन है कौन मोमिना है। आए हम भी दुआ करें कि हम सब की आकिबत बखैर हो, बहुत जरूरी है कि आकिबत बखैर हो। एक सिर मैं आपको देना चाहता हूं और वो सिर क्या है आकिबत बखैर? नमाज अव्वल वक्त। ये मरहूम की एक आदत थी, उन्होंने खुद भी मुझसे कहा कि नमाज वो अव्वल वक्त पढ़ते थे, वो कहते थे कि मैं नमाज अव्वल वक्त पढ़ता हूं। और रिवायत में ये भी है कि अगर इंसान नमाज अव्वल वक्त पढ़े मौत भी आसानी से होती है, किसी का मोहताज नहीं होता है। हां आजादारो, रोजे आशूरा भी अबू समामा ने नमाज को याद किया है ना, रोजे आशूरा अबू समामा ने इमाम हुसैन से कहा कि यब्न रसूल अल्लाह जोहर का वक्त है, इमाम ने क्या कहा? इमाम ने कहा ए अबू समामा, तुमने नमाज को याद किया, कयामत के दिन खुदा वंदे करीम तुम्हें नमाजियों के साथ शुमार करे। हा आजादारो, शहदाए करबला अहले नमाज में से थे, अव्वल वक्त पढ़ते थे और कितने खुशनसीब थे कि हुसैन के पीछे नमाज पढ़ते थे, वरना वहां पे भी नमाज होती थी लेकिन हुसैन के पीछे नमाज पढ़ते थे। कौन हुसैन? वो हुसैन जो आखिरी रुखसत के लिए जब आते हैं तो सलाम भेजते हैं, कहते हैं या ज़ैनबो कुलसूम या आतिका व रुकैया अलैकुन्ना मिन्नी सलाम, मेरा आखिरी सलाम कबूल कीजिए। उसके बाद गोशे में हुसैन ने फिज़ा को देखा, कहा ए फिज़ा मेरा आखिरी सलाम कबूल कीजिए। बस हुसैन जाना चाहते हैं मैदान की तरफ कि एक मर्तबा ज़ैनब ने भाई को रोका, महलन महलन यबना ज़हरा। अज़ादारो, रिवायत में अजीब जुमले मिलते हैं, जब भी ज़ैनब ने हुसैन को याद किया आशूर के दिन तो इस नाम से याद किया, ए मेरे माँ जाए यबना ज़हरा, ठहरो रुक जाओ
ruk jaiye yabna zehra amma zehra ki wasiyat yaad aati hai maa ne mujhse kaha tha ke husain aakhri rukhsat ke liye jab aaye to unki gardan mein bosa dena pucha gaya kyun kaha yahan pe shimr ka khanjar phirega ae bhaiya jhuk jaiye aapki gardan mein bosa do husain ne zainab se kaha اے بہنا آپ کی بازوں میں بوسا لینا چاہتا ہوں ان بازوں میں رسی باندھی جائے گی عزادارو عاشور کے دن حسین نے زینب سے کہا اے بہن صندوق میں میرا ایک پیراہن ہے مجھے وہ پیراہن دے دو لو حسین کو پیراہن ملا میں کہوں گا حسین اپنی زندگی میں کفن مانگتے ہیں پوچھا گیا کیوں کہا کہ یہ اشکیا یہ ملائین میرے اس پیراہن کو بھی نہیں چھوڑیں گے لہٰذا میں دو پیراہن پہننا چاہتا ہوں میں کہوں گا اے میرے مولا یہ ملائین ان پیراہن کو بھی نہیں دوسرے پیراہن کو بھی نہیں چھوڑیں گے زینب آپ کے بدن پہ آئے گی آپ کے لاشے پہ آئے گی زینب نہیں پہچانے گی کہ یہ بھیا کا لاشا ہے اسی لیے تو روایت کے جملے ہیں کہ زینب نے سوال کیا انت اخی وابن امی آیا تم ہی میرے بھائی ہو آیا تم ہی فاطمہ کے لال ہو عزادارو مجھے انصاف سے بتائے آپ ایک لاشے کو کیسے پہچانیں گے لاشے کو پہچانا جاتا ہے یا تو اس لاشے میں سر ہو یا لباس ہو میرے مولا اتنے مظلوم تھے لاشے میں نہ سر تھا نہ لباس تھا زینب بھی نہ پہچان سکی ایک مرتبہ جب حسین کے لاشے سے نہیں آواز آئی ہاں بہن میں ہی حسین ہوں ایک مرتبہ زینب نے مدینے کی طرف رخ کیا نانا آپ کے نماز جنازہ نے تو ملائکہ نے پڑھی یہ آپ کا حسین فاطمہ نے جس کو چکیاں پیس پیس کے پالا ہو امت نے یہ حال کیا اللہ لعنت اللہ للقوم الظالمین وسيعلم الذين ظلموا أي منقلب ينقلبون إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون رضا بقضائه وتسليما لأمره مؤمنين are requested to recite سورة فاتحة for مرحوم عباس by Nazarali الفاتحة